Ladies and gentlemen, look at this beauty. It's an old doglock. It's a kind of British flintlock pistol from the Civil War times. So it is nearly 500 years old, if I'm right. Yeah.
1660, that sort of date.
Yeah. Smoothbore, of course. Why did they call it doglock?
Because the original name for this type of pistol was a dag, a D-A-G, and the dag became the dog.
Is it functioning?
The only difference is this safety.
Yeah.
You see, and that locks into there, and is because they were carried on horseback almost exclusively, and then you would pull the hammer back to full cock, the safety rolls to the back, and then the trigger works like a miquelet,
draws
the piece in. And if you take the lock off, all these screws, well, they look like screws, they're actually rods with holes through, and they have little pins on the inside. They're pinned on the inside, not threaded. Option of these are threads, but the rest, they're all pinned on.
I mean, this is nearly where it all began. This pistol fired a self-contained cartridge because the bullet had a cavity in the base, which was filled with powder. It was closed with some kind of lid, for instance, to the carton or what?
It had a very thin cartridge paper end covered in fulminate, which was struck by the nose of the...
The fulminate gave the ignition to the cartridge, but there was no case. There was no casing. The bullet was the case itself. It's beautiful. Can I cycle it? First in my life to hold a Volcanic pistol and to cycle it. But it's not that easy.
It's not that easy at all, no. Certainly if you were trying to do
this
it...
You just think, my finger, or I'm weak. How many rounds can you put in?
I think it takes about eight or nine, which was a miracle for the
day.
Yeah,
the single shot pistol period. And it works like this, the Henry, so you have to...
Yeah, you draw this to the end, turn the barrel to one side, drop the bullets in. Powder was so corrosive, this area used to leak, and then obviously when you fired it, flame and what would be spitting out of here, and the guns got thrown away. Because the carrier is so small, it didn't lend itself to converting to other later calibers, so very few of them survive.
The story of the Volcanic repeaters is connected strongly to the history of Smith & Wesson and the Winchester firms. The toggle link action was originally patented by Horace Smith and D.B. Wesson in 1854. The company, located in Norwich, Connecticut, produced circa 1,000 lever-action handguns in 30 and 38 calibers. The name of the company was changed to Volcanic Repeating Arms in 1855, but the economy was slow, so a shirtmaker, stockholder of the Volcanic Repeating Arms Company, living in New Haven, named Oliver F. Winchester, acquired major share in the company. The firm was relocated to New Haven, and Horace Smith and D.B. Wesson left the business. By these times, the company was manufacturing a lever-action pistol and a carbine as well, in 38 caliber. In 1857, the company changed the name again to New Haven Arms Company. These rifles and pistols fired a special bullet called a racquetball, developed by Walter Hunt in the 1840s. The racquetball was a skirted bullet, with black powder charge filling the hollow base and the primer disc closing the bottom of the cavity. This was a straightforward concept, but the charge of the cartridge was limited by the volume of the bullet skirt, so it was not suitable for military service.
Please.
Second time I hold a Volcanic rifle.
Within 5 minutes.
I mean, this is where the lever action story begins, really. Look at the frame. This is nearly the same shape as the Henry rifle, but in a smaller version. And of course, it is the self-contained cartridge, also without the cartridge casing.
The hammer spring is quite weak on this one, though. Main difference is adjustable sight, but mechanism is identical.
This is the Henry rifle, so this is the Winchester time, the beginning of the Winchester period. This is firing a rim fire cartridge, which means that the ignition powder is pressed into the rim of the cartridge. This is it also has a brass cartridge. And this was the first time where you can load 14 plus 1.
This is
14 plus 1.
A very sensible repeating rifle,
and
very successful, and obviously led on to the most successful repeating rifle of all time, really.
Yeah.
Benjamin Tyler Henry, superintendent of the New Haven Arms Company, took the Volcanic toggle link repeating system and the concept of the tube magazine under the barrel and developed a new, stronger cartridge for his rifle. His original 200 grain flat nose bullet was propelled by 26-28 grains of black powder, held by a brass case. The igniting powder was pressed into the rim of the casing. Harry patented his rifle in October 1860. The tube magazine under the barrel held 15 rounds. The Harry saw service in the Civil War, but not in huge numbers, so it did not have too much impact on the outcome of the war. The new rifle was tested by the US Army and Navy as well, with nice results, but the cartridge was considered too weak for service. Altogether only 1,730 pieces found their way to the battlefield. The rifles achieved a good reputation with the rebels calling them the damn Yankee rifle you load on Sunday and shoot all week.
This is a Porter turret rifle. Now, with this, if I just take the safety off, this...
You load the chambers?
You load the chambers with the loading lever. And
yeah, this is the loading lever, so this is pressing the bullet.
Yeah.
Excellent. I thought that it's a hammer or something.
No, that's the loading lever. This little cover, just in case all the chambers go off together, this is to save your life.
Excellent.
And then when you work the lever, it cocks the hammer out the side, and then when you pull the lever back, as you see, it rotates the chamber into battery. When you pull the trigger, obviously the hammer goes through the side, collects a little fulminate pill from this rotary magazine.
Excellent. And this ages is around...
Earlier. This is 1852.
In 1852, there were better designs than this, for sure.
I agree. For years, a legend persists that Mr. Porter, who invented this rifle, killed himself demonstrating it to Colt. But this is false. This didn't happen. Yeah. But it was almost like he had to invent everything different, and everything he invented made a problem that he then had to invent something else to cover.
The Porter turret rifle is a clever but dangerous design. Perry W. Porter of Memphis, Tennessee, patented his arm in 1851 under the number 8210. The heart of the rifle is a vertically mounted turret with 9 chambers advanced by the lever under the stock. The Mueller-type hammer is cocked automatically by the action. The first versions used small pills of fulminate to ignite the charges. Later it was replaced by nipples and percussion caps. The rifle itself is just as dangerous to the user as to the enemy, as when firing the gun, you have at least 3 chambers pointing in the direction of the shooter. To make things worse, Porter also designed an automatic magazine loading system to feed the powder and the charge into the turret while activating the lever. What an excellent idea! If you luckily don't die because of the multiply discharge, you still have a metal box full of powder and balls to explode in your face. I tried to find some info about how Porter died to verify the legend. Unfortunately, all I found is his gravestone from 1856 from Elmwood Cemetery, Memphis. So did he die because of his own design? Good question.
It's a crazy rifle. This is a double rifle, 6-bore.
That's a millimeter, 20?
Yeah.
5.
About a quarter of a pound bullet, so...
Jesus Christ.
That's a lot.
Both barrels are rifled. Look at that. What was the standard load for this?
That would probably shoot around about 6 drams, 7,700 grains to a pound.
This is too much mathematics.
It's a lot, it's a lot.
Jesus, look at this 4 stuck.
But when you think what a place Africa was in 1790, I mean, you had a lot of other problems, not just what you were going to face animal-wise. So I think this rifle may have been made for an expedition into Africa. And they just didn't know what they were going to find. They may have found a dinosaur, do you know? They never knew what they were going to find.
Prepared for everything.
They took a ride.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.
Like a little...